Все может получиться.
Sportbets.com – уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. Sportbets.com – живой азарт и холодный расчет.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Room on Fire. See, the green screen's all messed up. It's not my fault, it's because the sunlight's actually coming in. I can't stop it. Well, I can, but it takes more preparation than I've currently got today. It's been a very busy day, of course, as we announced our own tournament here at Room on Fire in cooperation with Case King and Albin Foon and also Beat Phoenix. So that's really, really cool. A huge announcement for us. We're really, really excited about it. We've got €14,000 to make do with, and it's going to be a lot of fun. It's going to be a King of the Hill type theme, and you can read all about it if you go to Reddit or if you go to HLTV.org or if you go to OnGamers or wherever you like. It's going to be some news out about it. So definitely go and check that out, guys. Going to have some incredible stuff for you. But today, it's the SLTV Star Series that we've got coming up, Season 10. And actually, for once, I think we have some pretty cool teams for you guys to watch. Just to go through what the schedule is going to be like, it's HellRaisers LDLC, it's HellRaisers Epsilon, and then it is Fnatic versus LDLC. So, going to have a lot of fun stuff coming up. Really looking forward to seeing how LDLC are going to play. And, well, watching Fnatic play recently is definitely also not boring. So we'll see how it goes. Right now, we only have 3 members on the server. So that's a little bit sad. But I will still switch it over to the game just so you guys don't have to just watch me. Although you can watch the logo. I do like the logo. Helped, created by Hanso, who's actually been doing stuff for StarCraft 2, and he helped us out with it, so it's really cool. And we did bring you guys a little bit of a teaser, just in case anyone missed it earlier. The stickers there, I don't know if we're going to make these stickers, but if we do, they do kind of look pretty cool. Maybe we will, any kind of backup for it, if people want to have them, then we'll do it. But for now, let's say hello to Semler and Vendetta. How are you guys doing?
Doing swimmingly. Sun is shining outside and the birds are chirping, so nothing to complain about, really.
Lucky you, man. It's rainy and ugly here in Stockholm.
Well, I mean, it's been raining here earlier today, so I guess the worst part is over. But right now, it's starting to look up.
Yeah, well, that seems to be the case. Or at least, I mean, that's fitting, right? Man, that's fitting. You know, things are looking up after the announcement this afternoon, right? And then I was just like looking outside, I'm like, Stockholm, you gonna join in? You know, you're gonna brighten my day as well as the news? And nope, Stockholm doesn't care.
You'll get it at nighttime. It's gonna be like at 4 a.m. It's gonna be like super weather.
It's gonna be beautiful, man. Beautiful. Yeah. I'm gonna go sleep out on the balcony.
Sweet.
Although, to be honest, if it really is, like, really bad weather, sometimes it's kind of nice to take a walk in the rain. I mean, if you can get home and get, like, a warm shower or something, you should do that sometime. It clears the mind. I'm a big fan of that.
It's great, too. You have even more time for the mind to clear when you're in bed for the next 2 days because you're sick. So it's, like, really good, man. It's perfect. Perfect.
Come on, Vendetta and I don't get sick from stuff like that. We're from the north, man. This is true. It's only you people from like France and the US, and that's, you know,
so frail.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's why I've never. I think I've suffered once from event plague.
Yeah, and I get it every single time.
I am indestructible, man. It's like plague come at me.
Every single
land. It ain't got nothing on me.
No, every single land I get home, I get that land flu. I just can't help it.
So I just love it because something. Then I get to sneer at people and just be like, weaklings, you know, Pontus is the worst. I don't know why he gets paid to do his job because it feels like he's on sick leave more than he's actually at the office. Like, every week he's sick. I'm like, hey, man, I'm going to come by the office today, just, you know, chat it up a little bit. He's like, oh, man, don't come. I'm in bed. Like, what's going on?
It's just how it is, right? All right, look, we finally got some people on the server. So you two have joined up as well. I think I gave you the IP. About 1 minute left is what Angel says, and we are going to be on Inferno for a best-of-one game SLTV Star Series here between HellRaisers and LDLC. So welcome to the channel, and again, thank you for joining up here. If you recognize the voices but is confused about the channel name, that's, you know, that's not you being wrong. It is still myself and Semler and Vendetta doing work here, except the channel name has changed. And all that news you can also go and find on hltv.org or, you know, wherever else you feel like it. And just today, we announced a tournament that we're going to be doing for the next 3 months, which involves €14,000, Case, King, Bit Phoenix, and Alban Finn. So it's really cool that we got that kind of support for our new big project here. And we're obviously looking forward to it. But yes, welcome to the stream. Remember to follow if you haven't done it already. You know, tell your friends that this is going on. Are you guys ready for this game? HellRaisers LDLC, Vendetta, who do you think is going to be winning?
I want to say LDLC, simply because they have that, or for me, the kind of surprise factor, because I haven't seen LDLC play in quite some time. True. And we saw HellRaisers play last night, and obviously they did really well. Winning versus CSG, but there's something about French teams that go into hiding that always come out of hibernation very scary. So I'll put my money on LDLC for this game.
And what do you say, Semler? You went into hiding in France just a while ago in a cabin, and I was told it was beautiful. Did you come back stronger?
I did. And you know what? Apex was just on vacation last week, so I bet you Apex is going to be a monster. He's going to be refreshed. He's had plenty of wine. Plenty of croissants, lots of bread and pate. He's going to be feeling good, man. He's going to be ready to take on HellRaisers here. I feel it. Ben pretty much hits the nail on the head right there, is that we haven't really seen much of LDLC at all. I think they've had one group match so far in Star Series. They've won it, so they're 1-0 right now in the group, but it's still too early for that to really tell anything at all here for this tournament itself, but they weren't at DreamHack. We haven't seen them on LAN in ages. So they're kind of an unknown, whereas HellRaisers, well, we all saw the crazy performance out of HellRaisers at DreamHack Summer. We know where they're at.
Yeah, so it's going to be a little bit of a battle, you know, between the team. We know a little bit about these past couple of days, and then LDLC, we've just been saying, been in hiding for a while. If you're just joining us, then welcome to the channel. This is the SLTV Star Series Season 10, and you're on Room on Fire, HellRaisers, LDLC in a best of one. So welcome to the show, everyone. It's going to be LDLC starting off on the counter-terrorist side, and then HellRaisers on the terrorist side. I don't know if that makes the biggest difference on Inferno, but, you know, if LDLC get off to a good start here, it might just set the tone for the first half here.
Yeah, you can't really scoff at having a great start to a match. So I think it's always beneficial to start on the CT side, even though Inferno is a pretty balanced map. It just gives you that good feeling, and you have the opportunity to let that momentum keep going.
That little bit of confidence, right? And, yeah. You know, we're talking about them having been away from officials for a while. This you know, getting the start that they want on Inferno versus a team of HellRaisers quality, like, this is definitely what LDLC need. Now, they just need to be picking up the pistol, but what's already interesting is they've got four guys, three of them going mid, they're going to be taking the range fight.
Yeah, with a USPS, I can't really blame them, you know, at range, it's definitely better than the Glock, and look at how far up Apex is sneaking right up here, but Dosha turns around at the right time, Apex is going to take him down and then gets punished by Angel immediately, Adrian with a kill over at Banana, and this is not looking good for LDLC.
That's a very interesting play already. That's the thing. It takes a little bit too long for Apex to get in there, and it was going to be crucial for Uzi to hold on. He needed to stay alive in Boiler, and that just doesn't happen. Now HellRaisers, they've got a guy on the site, and the flank comes in from Kucher in Apartments. Happy is down.
A good headshot for Maniac, but it is too late at this point. It's a 1-on-3, and even if Maniac has the right call here, making his way over to the B-bomb site, no way in hell is he going to be able to do this 1-on-3, I think.
Well, it's going to be tough, no doubt. Who knows? Well, he doesn't have a kit, actually, so yeah, it is a pretty tall task.
Not a chance. So I think you already mentioned it, Semler. Basically, if he had walked up behind, was that Dosha he ran into?
Dosha, yeah.
Yeah, so if he had walked up behind Dosha and Dosha had been looking the other way and it would have been a one-shot headshot and that's how the match started, it would have been very different. But those, you know, 3 seconds that they fought in the middle, that was enough for the rest of HellRaisers to get into some good positions and get the frags.
What, I don't know, Ben, what do you think? Was it Uzi who was covering Apex? Like, I'm surprised that they didn't have harder support there watching towards second mid so that Apex didn't just get hung out to dry. Because that's the one thing, if he's pushed all the way down there towards mid, he wins that fight, great, but he needs to make sure that he doesn't get flanked, and I would expect a teammate to be there to make sure that doesn't happen.
Yeah, so that's absolutely, absolutely true. And but by the same token, I think Apex as well should have been able to finish up Dosha a lot quicker.
True.
And then they wouldn't have the same problem because Apex could then push on further and not get caught out from second mid. But I also think Kaylee made a bit of a mistake when playing that aggressively after Apex went down, and that kind of opened up everything and forced rotations from LDLC. But yeah, but really cool to see what HellRaisers keep on doing. Kucher still bought up the Deagle and the pistol. Angel keeps or continues to play with the CZ and the pistol as well. So they're definitely found something that they think is working for them.
Oh, look at Maniac. He's going to be walking right into someone who had a grenade out, and he actually does take the next kill, keeps shooting. The 5-7 is so good in that kind of situation. Dosha and Kucha down now. He's calling for backup quickly. HellRaisers are coming, but this is actually a pretty good position for LDLC. Maniac's still alive in the back. He does even more damage to Adrian before he finally goes down now. The rest of the French team just needs to step it up, and from the side, Apex going to walk in, takes the one shot. Still no bomb plant here, and it is a 2-on-2.
It's a 2-on-2, and LDLC has so much HP to work with here. They've got CZ-75s. That's near instant death for Angel or Adrian both if they get hit here. So HellRaisers have to play this so patiently. There's Happy finding Angel. Adrian takes the right peek and catches it, turns it into a 1v1.
Yeah, no kit here on Happy. He's going to have to move a little bit quicker, and he's maybe not quite quick enough. Adrian will pick up a quad kill at the end. Even though Happy had an AK picked up, it wasn't enough to win the round, but it is still a pretty good round from LDLC. That's 4 kills they got, and that could have easily been theirs in the end.
That was definitely a good round coming up from LDLC. I think, again, tiny mistakes prevent them from winning the round. I think Apex, again, should have waited a tiny bit more for, I think it was Kaylee who was the last man standing. But in any case, they should have gone together and pretty much sandwiched him when they were in that 2v1 situation, and Apex got a bit too eager and committed too far in.
Yeah, it felt like it. Especially because the bomb was just planted, so they have a little bit of time
exactly
to do that. Now, Apex is up in apartments waiting, and they're going to grenade the bedroom, and that's going to give Apex room to move up. He gets the one, and if he had realized there was someone else there, I think he could have actually just killed both. So, but I think he was actually in the middle of turning around to check if someone was behind him.
I like this play from Dosha over on B, though. He's taking a bit of a peek around. It's Happy who's holding the angle up on coils. He's going to look for a shot, take a bit of damage, and fall back. This is the important bit. He needs to stay alive. He's got support from a teammate here as well, Uzi. So HellRaisers, they're moving the bomb up banana. It looks like they want to make the B play after all. There's still defense here, however.
Yeah, and they do team up. Kucher and Dosha just making it work. Opening up the bomb sign, they're going to leave Angel over by the boiler room, and he's going to be walking out and taking an easy kill on Kaylee here in the middle with the AK. No problem. Now the question is Maniac going to be able to return on that? I think he made a little bit of noise. I'm not sure if Angel's heard yet. And now AK versus USP, generally not a favorable position, and he actually does bring Angel down to 21, and now he's probably dead.
Maniac just gonna back off to the site at this point? Is he trying to wrap around and hoping he's gonna catch somebody out on short? Looks like it. But the problem is the guy's doing the hunting. They've got plenty of HP to deal with the USP unless Maniac can get like a double dink headshot right off the bat. Not gonna happen though. So HellRaisers, 3 rounds now, and we go into LDLC's first buy round here in the fourth.
There it is. 3-0, and we're straight into the fourth round. Now, let's see what LDLC can do when they pick up rifles. Again, a quick shout-out to all of you guys out there in the chat who are subscribing. Thank you very much for doing that. And we do have subscriber mode on to keep the chat somewhat civil. And also to pay back the people that try and help us out. We really appreciate it. Now, what do you think, Ben? Rifles here? I mean, LDLC have been looking pretty good so far, I think.
Yeah, they had a pretty good eco round, so that's obviously good, even though they're behind 3-0. I don't really see anything special with LDL's setup. Pretty bread and butter setup from the Frenchman. HellRaisers are attacking the A-side fast here.
Yeah, and this M4A1 for Maniacs is a bit of a problem. He's going to run out of bullets. He's going to have to reload instantly. Only 20 bullets in that one. So if you miss some shots, you can just run out. But Apex doing great work as well. And Maniacs still down in the pit here. And this could be working out great. Happy coming out of the library. Going to take down one. And it's down to Kucha in a 1-on-4 here. So this works out brilliantly for LDLC. And if you look at it, they're all M4A1s. I mean, that in itself is actually a bit of a switch up for LD for any Counter-Strike team right now.
Yeah, it seems to be going a bit against the trends, I guess, because as of late, a lot of teams have been going back to the original M4.
Yeah.
So, yeah, curious to see why LDLC have opted to go for the Silenced Colt. But obviously, it's still a pretty good weapon. It's just the issue with the bullets. But as you said, or pointed out, it could have been an issue with the 20 bullets for Maniac, but yeah. It did the smart thing. He got the one pick off, and then he basically just ran the hell away because he knew he had teammates backing him. They had a solid crossfire planned out, and if you play that way, it's very doable to have all-out silencers, and the 20 bullet clip is not going to affect you that badly.
I'm just thinking that's going to be a nightmare if you're T-side running in and you don't exactly know where they are. Usually what you're looking for are like the tracer rounds, right? That yeah. gives you an idea, like, okay, he's holding from this spot, but you're walking into a crossfire and it's nothing but M4A1s. You're never going to actually see where the guy's coming from unless you get eyes on him.
That was a beautiful pickup from Angel down in the pit. And there's another one. Takes down Kaylee. Angel opening up the entirety of the A bomb site. And he's eventually going to get taken down. But Maniacs alone, he takes two kills quickly in return. This is going to be one hell of a match. I can already feel it coming on these teams. They are just in it to win it. Happy waiting here in the library. Markov going to peek in. He takes him down. And now Uzi is in a 1-on-3. And the bomb is down. So looks like another round for HellRaisers.
This is just going to be Uzi backing off at this point. It's the right call to make. 1v3 retake on A when the Triangle of Doom has been set up. It's just not going to happen. And I guess what's really big here, I don't know if they're going to have enough money for this, really. They're going to get 1,400 off of this round.
Yeah.
It's not going to be a whole lot to work with here for LDLC.
At best, LDLC can do an awkward force buy, and I'm not really sure if that's worth it. And I'm kind of hoping that they won't do it.
I feel like they might. If they save this one, I'm pretty sure they're going to just force it up.
That's the thing. Uzi needs to live here. They can't find him. He does. Okay, so now, yeah, he can drop an M4A1 for someone. They're definitely going to
be Maniac. Maniac's going to get a FAMAS, I think, and they'll go from there.
But it's not without issue, because one of the strengths, obviously, on this team is Kaylee's AWP, and he can actually use it on a map like Inferno. So when they force up like this, it kind of is the same as saying, we'll try without Kaylee's AWP for a while. And, you know, they got to be careful. Apex with the first pickoff, though, means, you know, forcing up this round so far has worked out all right for them.
This has definitely been a very strong start here for LDLC. I like to see Apex kind of playing to his style as well, not afraid to peek out mid, and not just peek, but then stand out there and go even farther to find that kill. He, like, stays there. He doesn't try and run away. He stays and gets the job done. That's very Apex style, right? So we need to be seeing that out of Apex. You know, maybe that Pate.
And speaking of Apex, just look at where he is. Been boosted up. And actually, I think someone just made a video on Reddit that shows you actually can jump up there yourself now. I swear I saw that. But either way, Apex got the boost.
This is a really... there's a bunch of little boosts now, actually, on the A site that are recent. Ask Rennie. Rennie's got like 3 of them.
Oh, and Apex, he actually jumps down and does get the kill on Adrian. So now they're going to sneak around through Archway. Maniac's going to spot them. And even though it just has the 5-7, it's still a lot of really good information being brought here to the CT side. They are going to let one guy through, and that's Angel. But HellRaisers is running out of time right now. Oh, they pick up the one kill, so that's what it's all about. They're going to wrap around back towards B, and Uzi's going to be alone. And the rest of HellRaisers, or LDLC, sorry, they're very slow to react.
They're all the way on the other side. Both of them now trying to figure it out, especially because Uzi's now calling to his teammates saying, I hear footsteps. You guys have to move and move now. 17 seconds left on this clock. Uzi has to get one. He drops the bomb carrier. Almost gets two. Brings it back to a 2-on-2 for his team, though. And now they've only got 10 seconds to plant this bomb, HellRaisers.
Yeah, not looking good right now for the Frenchman. They are in a 2-on-2. And oh, actually, that grenade works on Angel. Markov is in the back of sight. 1-on-2. The bomb is down, and he realizes where one of them is. Has the AK in hand. Just one click is all it takes, and he's going to take one down. But Maniac got him as well with the grenade. So finally, another round for LDLC. But they did lose 4 members. And I don't know. I felt like they left Uzi alone for a very long time.
The rotation was fairly slow. There's no denying that, but it all worked out in the end, seeing how Uzi managed to basically pick off the most important guy, which was the bomb carrier. And as long as he is able to his job, I guess, then they should be fine, even if it happens again. But yeah, it's a bit of an uncomfortable situation to be in, I think. And it puts a lot of pressure on Uzi. And we see Kaylee finally picking up that off that we were talking about. And yeah. It's paying dividends.
That's what they need, I think, to build an economy here. Have Kaylee with the AWPs. Also, he rotated back towards Archway. So if they try and cross over here, this is where Kaylee's really good. Picks off one, goes for a second. He actually misses that shot, but he still spots and misses one more. He's just using this pillar to try and hide behind. Eventually, he gets brought down, and it's actually a 3-on-3. And Maniac is in an interesting position. He's going to go down. He looked the wrong way when the smoke cleared. And now Happy takes another kill. Angel is down, but the bomb is at the bomb site.
Yeah, and now Happy spotted this from Library as well. They know exactly where he is, HellRaisers, at this point. He's going to be just trying to put shots in there, hope to get lucky. He's trying to stop the man from getting into pit, but that's not going to happen. Now we actually have Adrian, who is low on HP, in the best position for him on this site. But now he's all alone.
And he got smoked off as well. It's a very good time to save a smoke there. So that's going to be 1-on-2, smoked off on the site. He's going to have to walk out. They do have a defuse kit as well. Adrian now, he can see the bomb. Now they're going to have to come and get him. That smoke isn't covering the bomb fully, so LDLC, it's time to make up their minds and just move a lot quicker than they are right now. Adrian goes down to Happy. That should have probably been a kill on Happy, and Uzi already defusing. So good teamwork from LDLC, although I think it looked like they were hesitating a little bit again there.
That was a really awkward afterplant or a retake from LDLC, in my opinion. If yeah. Happy goes down there, that's probably a ramp for HellRaisers, because they did not go together at all. Uzi basically just sat on the bomb and was crossing his fingers that Happy would do all the work. Luckily, it worked out for them, but I wouldn't bank on that happening each and every time we're doing a retake. That was not as crisp as you'd like to see them do a retake.
And Kaylee, they did save the AWP, so, you know, just the last second, I think they managed to pick it up. So that's pretty good news. Kaylee gets to play around with that a little bit more. But now HellRaisers are switching it up. They are not so much focused on mid control. Taking their time before they even peek in here. Kaylee is maybe going to face off against Dozier. Deagle versus AWP. It can work out.
It can. What's interesting about this is that HellRaisers, I thought that they would eco at this point because several of their players were below the 3k mark. But they do actually go for a buy in which Dozier drops an AK from Markelov and just goes for the Deagle. Like, HellRaisers, they don't believe in ecoing at this point. They're just looking to try and keep the pressure up on LDLC as much as possible because, as Ven has explained, you know, LDLC are looking a bit shaky and HellRaisers are definitely going to notice that.
It looks like they are going to go for a B execute this time, and probably a very... It's going to be up to Uzi and Happy at the back of the site to see if they can hold on to it once it happens, but look at Apex also rotating over. This is some pretty good mid-round calling coming out from LDLC at the moment.
This is excellent. This is excellent from Apex. He's already close by. He's going to be able to rotate and support his teammates, but Uzi already picks off one. Uzi with two, and Happy lends a hand. Great defense!
Yeah, exactly what they needed to do right there.
Oh, Apex gets caught, but still, LDLC.
Oh, and a bit of a bump, I think, in the stream. Sorry about that, guys. I think it should be up and running again, but we did... Yeah, I think I just had a brief disconnect on my internet, so sorry about that.
Oh. Alright, well, we should be back up. Hopefully, they were able to catch that, because that was actually a pretty sick hold by LDLC. About as clean as you could get.
We caught the hold, and I think it disconnected right afterwards.
Well,
so,
right now...
We are back again.
The thing to take away from this is that now HellRaisers have finally been forced to eco.
And that's actually a rare occurrence, because HellRaisers are the least eco-happy team I think you'll ever see in CS.
Yeah, and this goes a really long. I mean, this goes a really long time back, doesn't it? In Russian Counter Strike.
Oh yeah, they refuse to eco. If they have the opportunity to get some sort of firepower, they'll buy it, and they'll run with it. And a lot of the times, it'll seem crazy and borderline stupid, but sometimes it works as well, and they look like geniuses because it completely messes with the other team's economy, and they get such a big advantage from it that it's indescribable. So, yeah, there is method to their madness, but it's weird to look at, really, a lot of the time, because it feels so reckless.
Mm-hmm. I think it's just the confidence that they have, especially when they've come so close to picking up rounds. You know, one member of LDLC surviving, two members, you know, just barely hanging in there. Great shot from Doja to pick off Kaylee at the top of Banana. Uzi comes in and picks off Poocher, but then Doja walks in, two for him, and that's actually the B-side completely cleared up. Happy's only just now rotating in through CT.
Yeah, grenade is going to rain in. Dosha takes no damage from it. So 3-on-3 retake of the B bomb site. And again, LDLC kind of slow with the rotation. You see Maniac only now getting the orders to actually get here. Now Dosha hiding in a corner. He's already got the double. He's looking for one more, and he's going to get it. Triple for him. Keeps spraying and almost takes down Apex. 2-on-2, and the bomb is down, and Maniac is now going to be alone as Markolovs gets that kill on Apex.
Looks like Maniac is gearing up to go for this. I mean, he's floating on the other side of that smoke, but he's quickly running out of time here. He does have a kit for the defuse, but with the position that HellRaisers are holding this from, this is terrific. Angel's about to take a peek. He's going to catch him out. That's excellent. I mean, Markolov distracts from the site, and Angel gets the flank.
Yeah. I mean, that is, you're right, the positions from HellRaisers, I think, made that retake very, very hard, considering the time they had left. At least you can say the French have got enough rounds on the board here in a row. They got 4 in a row, which means they can still buy. But they don't have a lot of money. If they lose this upcoming round, then they're going to be ecoing.
Yeah, and HellRaisers have already accumulated quite a few rounds, so they're on the right track right now. So it's up to LDLC to really go on another run like the 4-round streak we just saw.
Look at Markolov. I mean, Markolov has got the AWP. Right now it's Adrian who's just madly spraying in apartments, and he somehow chases Kaylee down. So that's a great opening kill there from HellRaisers. Markolov, yeah. I think, is still hanging around on the other side of the map looking for a kill with that AWP, but not yet.
It takes some real confidence to take an AWP into apartments, and if you miss a shot, well, we saw the result already. But I like the fact that LDLC are still going kind of aggressive here. They're going to walk right down. Adrian goes down now. Up in the actual window room, Angel is waiting, and they're going to try and double team, and they will take the kill, so this is working out. A pretty big risk, I would say, for LDLC to double up in apartments once they've already lost the AWP there, but it's kind of cool that it works out. Now, the question is, are they going to leave Uzi alone like they did last time? It seems like Happy's already on his way.
They're getting the read, aren't they? They've already figured out exactly where HellRaisers want to take this. 30 seconds left on this clock means that HellRaisers, they're pretty much committed to this site at this point. They're running out of time to make it back over to A site. Team LDLC, I mean, they've got two guys holding solid on this B site already. This is going to be very tough. And once again, HellRaisers, they're looking to sneak their way in.
Yeah, Markolov had an AWP, I think, or he has one. I think he could actually have got the kill on Happy if they had let him peek first. So, not sure why they went for the route that they did. Now, in the back, Happy, Byflower's going to take down one. Uzi peeks. Look at the time here. 8 seconds, and that's the bomb down. Markolov should be running away, but he is just insisting on trying to get one last kill, and he will go down 1 second before the timer runs out, which is good news for Markolov. Otherwise, he would have got no money for losing that round. But speaking of money, it's not looking good for HellRaisers right now.
It really isn't, but this is the kind of range where you could see HellRaisers buy up, but they actually off to eco, so...
Especially now that the deagle's been buffed, right?
Oh yeah, well, you've got so many viable pistols that... I think it's borderline too many viable pistols, it's crazy.
It's interesting, you still got two purists on HellRaisers' side, you know, two P250s have been bought, three CZ75s though, so... HellRaisers, they know what's up, get the mini AK. And just go to work right now. If they can, they're looking to get up into apartments, which is good because, I mean, close quarters, right? They can really put those pistols to use up here. It's going to come down to Maniac on balcony here. He's about to peek around the corner, and guess what? Angel is waiting with the pistol, gets the instant shot.
Yeah, Apex trying to return, gets the one, gets taken down, and now they need that swift rotation. LDLC, this is very likely going to be a bomb plant for HellRaisers, and then the question is, I mean, giving up to rifles, this is looking really bad.
What I really like about this is the bomb delay on HellRaisers. It's always so late to come that LDLC, I think that cost them a couple seconds on the rotation because they never see the bomb. And now Kucher, he's in pit, looking towards short. Nobody there. Doja with the P250 will take out Uzi. Now he's got a gun in his hand, and it's a 2-on-4 situation. LDLC, this is so difficult.
They're going to have to run. That was an incredibly sloppy round from LDLC. And I think... To just not to put all of it on them exclusively, I think this was also down to the way that they held that bomb site, just timed perfectly with the type of push that HellRaisers were doing. Kaylee does get a good no-scope in, but it's not enough. He's going to lose the AWP, and now in turn the Frenchmen don't have a lot of money.
Yeah, this is this is the result HellRaisers are looking for whenever they do one of these forest buys, and they manage to do it without spending much money at all. With that eco, so great round from HellRaisers. But yeah, I agree. I think the setup was ultimately not that great, and in addition to that, they got kind of timed by HellRaisers, so yeah, that was just everything going against LDLC. But you still can't discredit HellRaisers. I mean, that's some pretty sick shots. The opening frag from Angel was was crazy.
And it looked really, really good. And, you know, Angel's been getting a fair few opening frags so far in the game. He's actually the top fragger in total. 11. Well, Apex is up, you know, at 14. But on his team, it's the Angel show currently, which is great. I mean, Angel's actually been one of the people, I think, who's been struggling a little bit on HellRaisers. So to see him step it up as the top fragger, which he really should be one of the top fraggers, it's kind of cool.
Sloppy play. They're using two smokes to block off CT going into this B site. There's still a man alive, however, on this site. It's going to be one for Happy with that CZ. Manages to pick off Doja. But now, LDLC, they've got a man in construction. It's Maniac, but the bomb is about to get planted, and there's full control of B site for HellRaisers.
Yeah, they've just smoked out every entrance. Just a question of the smoke clearing, then Maniac trying to see if he can get a pick off on somebody. If he can, great, but I don't really see it happening. More than likely, it's just going to be him going down as soon as they figure out where he is. He's got body armor, so if he really wanted to, he could try and save it. I mean, they don't really have that much money, so anything that they can get right now. This is a very good first half for HellRaisers, we've got to say this much.
Oh, absolutely. And it's not like... I mean, they've already gotten 7 rounds, and who's to say they're not capable of getting 9 at this point? Because LDLC are not in the best place money-wise. You see Uzi buying up the FAMAS. And if they lose this round, they've spent all the resources. And at that point, it's pretty much a free round for HellRaisers, barring them messing it up.
So now the big question is, I mean, and, you know, it's an open question. HellRaisers on the terror side, but, you know, on the CT side of Inferno, how good would you say they are, Ben?
I think they're extremely uneven. I think they're one of the few teams that could either shut down any team in the world, 13-2, for instance, on the CT side, or they could just be a complete mess and not do proper rotations and all that kind of stuff and lose 13-2 on the CT side. So I'm a bit interested to see what kind of HellRaisers show up today. But from what we've seen so far, I think they should be in for a really strong CT half.
Well, we are about to find out. We're in the 14th round of the first half. This is a best of one game, and currently HellRaisers with a 1-round lead. Uzi just trying to do a little bit of shoulder peeking, trying to see if he can catch anyone. And he actually peeked just as somebody walked past. The timing on that was so unfortunate, and he goes down. So that was... Oh, man, if we replay that in slow motion, it'd be even more horrible to watch. Great grenade rains in, and actually Happy takes one down for the smoke, and that's what they need. They got to win this round. If LDLC lose this, they're going to be ecoing, and it will be 9 rounds for HellRaisers in the first half. And there's a shot. Headshot straight onto Adrian. Flashes rain in. Bomb is down, and Kutra and Doja trying to defend. Doja with a good kill comes in for another one, gets a double, and then finally is taken down. But Kutra in the back looking for a headshot is not going to get it. Apex will pick up a quad kill in the round and put himself at 18 total. I mean, this is kind of old school LDLC, isn't it? With Apex just carrying a lot.
I could agree with that. I mean, right now it just seems like Apex, that was one of his rounds, right? He was always in the right place at the right time, and when he got the opportunity, he managed to land those shots, starting off with one at quad through the smoke. I think Happy's was almost just as important. It was just so important as well to slow HellRaisers down. Him being in CT spawn and getting lucky through the smoke with the timing, but still taking out Markloff like that was really important for LDLC to make that happen.
The initial mistiming from Uzi was kind of tragic. Oh, wait a minute. Great double pickup from Apex. I'm sorry I missed that nearly. Just him rushing up in apartments. I thought he was just going to go and, you know, and control apartments, not actually go all out aggressive. In second mid, he saw the bomb as well, so a lot of information early on for LDLC and some good kills coming in, though Adrian will return, and it's back into a 3-on-3.
Oh, this is great. Adrian's going for the roast. It's going to be Uzi. He manages to make it away from the molly just in time, though. Been a while since we've seen those kinds of strats come out here, however, from HellRaisers, from any team on the T side of Inferno. You know, it used to be for a while there that Molly's, that was like the go-to grenade to use to get onto B site.
Yeah.
So, you know, at least Adrian, you know, he's showing, yeah, we still remember him, we still know how to use him.
Right, gonna be another B push coming up. Last time Uzi did get almost a double kill, but he at least got the one, and he has to get one this time as well. Katie's kind of close by with an AWP, but that smoke's gonna prevent him from using it all that effectively. Great kill for Uzi. Now he needs another one before he can really secure this for his team, and he's very low on health, and he will go down. Kaylee tries to find another angle, but this smoke is just really messing with him at this point.
Well, that's the problem. He's got that AWP as well, so if he's so close, if he misses a shot, he's gonna be in a world of hurt. And right now, it's going to be Maniac just trying to draw the attention, set up for his teammate to take a peek. Kucher will find Kaylee, though. It's now Maniac in the 1v2. And he gets caught by Kucher from Coils. That was another very clean round for HellRaisers, managing to make it up there and get rid of Uzi fairly quickly.
Yeah, Kucher top fragging at the end of the half for HellRaisers. But I would say I've had to point out one thing for LDLC is that they seem to have some very inadequate rotations, really. I think, you know, it wasn't that they couldn't kill people once they got into positions. It's just that they rotated incorrectly.
I think that's the fair assessment. Might be some vacation rest, I guess. As we said, we haven't seen them all that much as of late. So that might be what it comes down to. And it's really important to have crisp rotations and correct rotations, obviously, when you're playing at this level. Because as a team like HellRaisers, is going to punish you anytime you make a mistake.
Yeah, that was what we saw, right? That's what we saw at the beginning of this game. Now, the second half is going to be coming up. So if you're just joining us, then welcome to the stream. You're watching the SLTV Star Series Season 10, LDLC versus HellRaisers. Second half coming up, and you're on Room on Fire. So welcome, everyone. And remember to follow the channel, of course, and we'll really appreciate it. LDLC, Semler, the pistol round. Are they going to get it, you think?
I'm really curious to see, because they bought a lot of decoys here and they're chucking them up mid. But then rather than try and rush around and really put pressure on HellRaisers early, they're slowing down the pace and spreading out across the map right now. So is this a QK strat? This almost seems like a QK strat. They put two guys up into apartments, LDLC. Well, one of them dead, so that's not going to help things too much. But they want to try and force the rotation to A from HellRaisers and sneak the bomb up banana, but that's just not going to happen anymore.
No, and look at the two people in B. They are actually going to go and find out who's out here, and they will do so with a CSET 75 on Angel. Takes one down, and then Andrin with an absolutely sick shot right through a very narrow crack all the way up on top of the wood stacks. And it's another LDLC player down. Now Maniac and Kaylee trying to bring it back, and it's not easy. Maniac missing some shots here. He's down on 10 HP, and Kucha will finish him off, leaving Kaylee alone in a 1-on-4. And even if he gets these two, it's still going to be a pretty long battle ahead.
He's still sitting at 100 HP. He's got Kevlar, so he can take a bit of a fight. He has to worry about Angel now. An insta-give. Angel doesn't miss the shot. Hell of a shot there, actually. But that's HellRaisers picking up the pistol round. And them being on the CT side, picking up the pistol, that's got to put LDLC on edge. That's two pistols now for HellRaisers.
Yeah, it's definitely a great start for HellRaisers, but I'm actually a bit disappointed that Apex got picked up so early. It seemed at least like he was supposed to be the catalyst of whatever LDLC wanted to execute, because he was the only one kitted out with grenades. Mm-hmm. So you have to imagine that the smoke and the flash that he had was meant to have some sort of a role in what LDLC were doing, and him getting caught off that early and Maniac not being able to pick up the smoke, that probably messed up quite a bit for them.
Certainly feels like it, and now they're doing a lot of work here. Dozier fighting off against Happy, who's the only one left, and Happy's actually going to pick up the kill now. If only he had the bomb. This would be such a good round from LDLC, meaning they could get the bomb down and obviously get a lot more money on that side. Now instead, he's fighting and almost takes down Adrian. Could have been a one-on-one, so overall, it is a pretty respectable round from LDLC, but I still kind of wish he would have had the bomb then.
Well, it would have given him options, right? He may have caught somebody from HellRaisers off guard, out of position, something along those lines. That was still a pretty good second round, however, LDLC getting three kills like that. Maniac in particular, I mean, he killed one on short, did a 90-degree turn, and picked off the second one over at Arch. So that was really big play there for Maniac with the P250. Right now, HellRaisers, they have to be feeling pretty confident. Things are going their way.
Oh, and Angel is confident. He's just pushing up, walking and shooting at the same time and getting some good headshots in. Apex really wants to go a little bit aggressive here, but you know, with a Glock, it's kind of hard to take that kind of aggression seriously. They're going to finish off him and the chicken with a grenade, and as Dozier taking down Maniac for the final kill of that round. 11-7, the 4-round difference, and now LDLC are going to be able to buy. And if they want any chance of winning this, the name of the game is simply trying to starve HellRaisers. Make sure they have no economy at all, and that they're ecoing a lot more than they're buying.
It's what they have. They have to make. They have to put HellRaisers in the same position that HellRaisers put them in on their CT half. That's it. So just force buy, keep the pressure up, do some damage, because that last round was not good enough. HellRaisers now have a bit of a cushion for the round to come. If things go south for them here, they're not in a position where they would have to eco, say, if they lost this one. So LDLC, they've got their work cut out for him here. They need to land a strong shot to start. Apex has to step it up, and he's just spraying in apartments right now, hoping to catch somebody off guard.
Oh, that was a beautiful grenade. Markov threw a grenade that just did 51 damage to Apex. As you said, he was up there in the apartments making a lot of noise. Markov just told him to calm it down.
It's late. It's late at night. Got a kid sleeping.
Tries to take a battle here with the Maniac. FAMAS versus AK. Got to be pretty careful about doing that. Markov's feeling confident right now. And LDLC are burning some time off the clock in the meantime. It feels like it's going to be an A push eventually. And when it comes, I'm wondering, do they have any set smokes that they're going to throw? Yeah, they do. Look at Apex here. So this is going to be for the truck, making sure anyone in pit with... Right now, there's nobody in pit. We know that. But they don't. If anyone was, then they'd be smoked off completely. So this is really worth watching, because this is going to determine a lot about how LDLC's push is going to happen.
See how things break down here. Markloff, he's got a great position, actually. The smoke on the truck isn't totally blocking off his sight, so he can still look towards short. He's going to be crucial here. Markloff needing to put the damage down on LDLC. He tags too.
They're going to plant. Look at this. This is a Fnatic-type strat. They're going to plant in the smoke, and HellRaisers, finally, they come up with a kill here. Kaylee goes down, but the bomb is planted, and it's a really weird 4-on-5 retake. Well, HellRaisers, they've given up the bomb plant, even though they still control the whole of the A bomb site. How is this going to play out? Happy's up close here in apartments. They must know somebody's up here. And now the battle's definitely on, and it's all HellRaisers all the way. They retake it without losing a single member. What a great round.
Well, that's all down to them recognizing what kind of strat LDLC is running. That's pretty much it. You could see that they had the perfect setup to really counter that after plant and really just punish LDLC. And again, that's one of the more difficult things about that strat that was executed by the French team. You're obviously going to get the bomb down most of the time, but actually defending it, it's so much harder than what it is with the similar tactic toward the B bomb site.
Yeah.
So much more difficult, and you saw how easily HellRaisers dismantled them once they recognized the situation and figured out what was going on. It was just an avalanche of kills from HellRaisers' side.
Yeah, because there's not that many places you can really hide as a terrorist. I mean, you are just going to be found in the two spots, basically, where you can hide. Markloff opening up this round with a really good kill, and now LDLC, they need an opening. And looks like it's Apex once again who's going to try and see if he can get them one.
Markloff going to peek 40, picks off Apex. Or no, that was Maniac, rather. Or Kaylee. But still, Markloff living with 1 HP. That's actually the slap in the face there for LDLC. That's got to be painful. They know Markloff is low, but then you've got four full HP members left for HellRaisers, and they've spread out across the map at this point. Nothing is going LDLC's way.
No, I feel like they're trying to make this too... I really want to see them try for like a really standard B push the next round. See if they can just get in there, get the bomb down, try and defend it.
Pull the HellRaisers. Oh.
Just want to see them doing something basic that seems to work, because I feel like some of these strats are a little bit too reliant on them getting some opening frags, and since they're not really getting those, it's kind of hard to believe in it, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It is. I actually have, you know, for the sake of LDLC, I've been trying to find some sort of hold in HellRaisers setups, but they're doing pretty vanilla setups, and... But the way they're playing, it just seems like they're going to be really hard to break. I don't really see how LDLC can do something with an extremely basic strat unless they hit their shots as well, which I guess is kind of a given, but they've been outgunned by HellRaisers for the better part of this game.
Yeah.
So this is going to be really tough for the French team, and it's not going any better right now in this round. Two men down already, and... Yeah.
I think that's the consistency here, is that look, if you look at the scoreboard, it's just spread out all across the map right now for HellRaisers. Like, everybody is double digits. Everybody is really just kind of pulling their weight. Doesn't matter where they are on the map or what position they're playing, they're still getting kills. Whereas LDLC, it seems a bit more staggered. You know, Apex sitting firmly at the top and then kind of drops off from there. So we really do need to see LDLC just start landing some shots, because even if they go for a bread and butter play, unless they can manage to pick up that entry to ease them in, it's going to be rough.
Yeah, I think one big issue is that normally we're used to see a player like Kaylee do quite a lot of the heavy lifting for LDLC, because he's just that good of a player, and he's not having the greatest of games right now. So that might have something to do with it, or it probably has something to do with it.
Now it's time to see this may be the last chance for the French team to actually make some sort of impact, and they will start off taking down Kucho, running into Markolov, and he's going to go down as well. A lot more aggression this time. Instead of sort of sneaking around trying to see if they can get the pickoffs, they just force their way in. Dosha defending is going to go down as well, so 4-on-2, although three of the players from LDLC are very low on health, and Angel's going to take down one. Molotov to follow, bomb does go down, Katie's going to be forced out, and he takes down one, and this should still work out for LDLC.
This is a great position. There's a great nade, though. Apex kills himself.
Gotta be joking.
How do you do that, Apex? And now Adrian, he's looking towards apartments. The thing is that Happy is so far away right now. Adrian is wasting so much time checking the likely spots on this map to hold from.
Oh,
but it's not
God.
Even going to matter.
No, he's going to go for the fake once again. Grenade is in. Happy's a little bit anxious. He's going to peek, and he does take him down, even though Apex did his very best to see if he can throw that round away. What a grenade. I think he meant to throw that in between the truck and, you know, just, you know, in somewhere in the hole in the truck, I think he is. Yeah, so I think he wanted to throw it, you know, between the back of the truck and this pillar from the pit, and then it sort of bounced on him and he just died. I wish we could have caught that.
It looked a great moment. It looked pretty awkward there, yeah. That's a shame, but still, HellRaisers, I mean, that buys LDLC a little bit of breathing room, right? But it's not a whole lot, because HellRaisers, they're still one round away from match point. This is still everything for HellRaisers, and the money is still there as well for them. So, HellRaisers have everything still to win this match.
Yeah, it's a long road ahead, there's no doubt about that. This time, though, Dosha does go down to 12 HP, and if they can force HellRaisers to eco, which is going to take a while, maybe there's a path back into this game for them. Markolov, though, will pick off Maniac, and we're back to a point in time where LDLC are not the ones getting the entry frags.
Let's see, Apex snuck his way up onto short. That's a good kill onto Markolov to open things up here. He's running a diversion right now, though. The bomb, they are going to bring the bomb back towards A. No, they decide to call for B. LDLC, they're all over the place right now, but three guys are gathering up in Banana, and they're going to make this play for the B site.
Kucha takes down one, and this is something that Kucha is just very good at, holding that defensive AWP. I think that's a real strength on Hellraiser's side, just having him. But Adrian's alone in the bomb site. Very likely there's going to be a smoke landing right here, so he's going to be completely alone. And just like when Uzi was on the side, he's going to have to pick up at least a couple of kills. Already flashed, he does do a lot of damage to Uzi, and now they're all coming for him. He goes down, so maybe there's an opening here. The rotation from this time from Hellraiser's is very slow.
Look at how quickly Angel is in here, though. He's going to catch one man off guard. Almost gets the double! So close! But Apex, it looks like Apex are happy. Happy Max manages to get behind new boxes. This is going to make things much more difficult here for HellRaisers. Two guys rotating in from CT spawn, but they don't have a whole lot of health to talk about.
They are all coming in from flowers, it seems. Now, one guy's going to enter into the main, but they are very low. You're absolutely right. Happy looking. They're actually both looking the same side. Now they're finally switching it up. Apex going to take down one. Peeks out, gets another one. And now Dosha in a one-on-one triple from Apex. And he's looking to make it a quad, and he will do that. This is Apex on 24 kills, outfragging everybody, including everyone on HellRaisers. And we're at 14-9 as a scoreline. And HellRaisers, they use a lot of money to buy this round. If they keep losing rounds here, the comeback could happen.
Now, the comeback is definitely alive. It's definitely a possibility here. I think LDLC are getting a tiny bit lucky, actually, to get onto these sides, because they seem extremely indecisive in where they want to go. That round, I think they changed, or it looked like they were changing opinions of where they wanted to go about four or five times before they actually decided on the site. And I think that was after Apex got the frag on Kucha and Arch, which was fairly late into the round. So I don't think they can keep on being that indecisive for the rest of the game.
This time they did something cool, though, which we've seen for a while now, obviously boosting up on this thing right here at the T-ramp and just looking over the smoke that HellRaisers put down, and I was happy picking up the kill, though. Uzi, who was the guy he was standing on, did take a lot of damage, so that seems unfair. Happy gets to add another frag, and Uzi takes a lot of damage.
And it's going to be, I mean, right now it's going to be Kucher, and just as I say his name, he gets caught off guard. He was out in the middle of nowhere. Great opportunity for LDLC. Now they've got a two-man advantage moving in on the A site, but there's still two members alive here for HellRaisers. Markolov and Doja each getting a kill. That slowed things down. Markolov still alive in the pit. Gets another, and there's a second for Doja. What goes from a two-man advantage just vanishes.
Yeah, and what seems like a huge throwaway from LDLC's point of view. I mean, that was truly devastating to watch. Ben, how did they not kill at least one of the two in the pit?
I'm not really sure how Markov survived. The first kill is just Markov having a better position than the LDLC player coming running in towards the site, but the LDLC player was on top of castle or graveyard. I have no earthly idea how he did not take out Markov. So, yeah, it seemed, again, it's HellRaisers winning aim duels and that sort of stuff that's really doing the difference right now, because LDLC are not killing the people they should be able to kill and who they normally are able to kill. But still pretty, I mean, still great performance from Markov and Doja holding off that four-man attack towards that A bomb site all by themselves.
It was like two kills each and just so solid.
Well, I don't want to take anything away from HellRaisers. I mean, once they see the opportunity, they just win the rounds, and that's what you want to do. I'm just a little bit questioning what... Oh! No question about that, though. Kucha picks up the double kill with one shot, and then he gets taken down by Maniac with a pretty good shot through the smoke, but Maniac's going to peek over what he really wants to pick up a rifle. He's just not going to be able to, and, you know, if they just keep these positions, I think this is game. Doja and Markov have already shown once what they can do here at the pit.
Doja's going to get a good flash out there. He catches Uzi completely out. And this is just falling apart at this point. Happy is still alive. He's waiting under short. In the smoke, he goes jumping, gets caught by Doja, just barely on the edge there. And that's going to be it. 16-9 win for HellRaisers in this Star Series group. And that's actually putting HellRaisers up there, right?